Canoeing offers you the possibility of enjoying nature at close quarters. Competition is another possibility which canoeing offers you, where you can measure your effort against others, either in kayaks or in canoes. In still water competitions, canoes compete in C1, C2, and C4. The shortest distances are 500 meters and 1,000 meters. The distance is covered in straight lines and in lanes. Resistance races are 5,000 meters, 10,000 meters, or even more. And various buoys are negotiated along the route. In speed or resistance races, the paddling technique is crucial in order to obtain good results. For some coaches, this is a real challenge. With our friends' help, we hope to make things easier. Let's go step by step. The canoe is logically the basic piece. Made of wood, fiberglass, or carbon fiber. The dimensions are limited by the regulations. The shape, the length, the width, and the weight. The wooden grille adapts itself perfectly to the hull of the canoe. This offers a flat surface where the canoeist can adjust the knee pad and footrest to his liking. The knee pad is where the canoeist rests his knee. The dimensions vary, but these can serve as a reference. The gap for the knee is anatomical and slightly oblique and should be reasonably comfortable. The knee pad should be fixed to the floorboard by some kind of brace so that it can transmit the propulsive force sent by the knee to the canoe. The footrest ensures a resting place for the back foot. Adding a strap will keep the foot in place against the footrest. The front foot rests on the floorboard. Some canoeists use non-skid tape on the floorboard to prevent slipping. Here, we also have a small foot pump. In team boats, the equipment is similar to that described. T2, the knee pads rest partially against the hull, and the height of the gap is slightly greater. In C4, the height is even greater, so that the canoeist is better situated. The paddle is the canoeist's contact with the water. It consists of three parts. The T-handle should be comfortable and permit good control of the paddle. The shaft is a round tube. The pulling hand is placed on the lower part. And just below, we find the wear strip. The blade is the part which contacts the water. It represents slightly more than a third of the overall length. The face is flat, except for a small ridge which acts as a division. But the backside is rounded. The bottom edge should be perfectly finished to ensure a clean entry into the water. The overall profile of the blade must allow for an easy extraction from the water. On a practical level, the length, the blade surface, and the positioning of hands is crucial for a canoeist to make the best of his physical and technical possibilities. As an example, we may say that the length of the paddle should be 8 to 12 centimeters shorter than the height of the canoeist. The positioning of the hands also varies. The system used by Narciso can be very useful. This can be checked later in the water. Although the differences are slight, not all canoeists hold the paddle in the same way or use the same proportion in length. The difference is dictated by the canoeist's physical build and his own paddling technique. In order to make the blade effective for a longer period in the water, there are some which have a small angle. On embarking, the canoeist should place the knee pad 15 to 20 centimeters behind the center of the canoe. So that when the boat is still, the bow is slightly higher than the stern. Then when the canoe is in movement and the canoeist transfers his weight forwards, he can partly avoid the sinking of the bow. On the other hand, the knee is placed 2 to 5 centimeters to the side of the center line on the paddling side. The rear footrest is angled about 20 degrees to the offside. These resting points, together with the front foot, form a triangle which represent the canoeist's resting point in the canoe. The angle of the front leg exceeds 110 degrees. From behind, we can see that the back is vertical, or leaning slightly towards the water. In team boats, the position is similar to C1. The greatest difference we can see is the proximity of the knee to the side of the canoe. In general terms, the canoeist must adopt a position which is reasonably comfortable and which permits him to keep his balance and control the canoe, but above all, it must be compatible with his